comes in his new rag. He's an experimental man. He stands pinning his hand like Edward Scissorhands, who slices competition and just goes about his business. Anyone who knows about a shindig, shenanigans, and all his wacky antics in the paper. What's up, guys? Hope you're doing well. Today is the second episode of the training log series. I know it has been a while from the first episode. The reason why I didn't upload the second part before was because when I recorded the pilot and the first part, I decided to not do any more parts unless I get a tripod, because let me tell you, it was a pain in the ass to record that first part. I had to stack a chair on top of a chair, then put a cardboard box on top, then yoga blocks, then support my phone with a fucking bottle. As you can see, super awkward, and the phone would fall off very regularly, so I had to stop mid-set and redo the set again. I did like 15 sets that session per muscle probably, so that's why I probably got DOMS after. But being completely like serious, I finally got myself a tripod, so this style of content is back and you're going to get more training logs, and this is going to be the primary way in which you see me train. And the reason why that is because before I would upload superset style videos, right? I would just do a superset and that's it. Or I would upload shorts. The thing is that I deleted those videos because now I want to prioritize quality over quantity. I want my videos to provide some type of value, and on top of that, I want them to meet a certain quality quota. For that reason, I deleted my old content. This video is going to be mainly to talk about an issue that I have been having with the community, or a problem that I have had in my head and I have been reflecting on for a while, and I didn't really know if I wanted to make a serious video about this, so I just decided to tack it on to a training log as a form of rant, and you can tell me what you think in the comments below while you see me work out. So the problem at hand is the decline in the quality of content of the community. Now, today, the date that I'm recording this, NH uploaded a new video in which he's going to stream, he's going to make Q&A, so that might revive the community again, I don't know. But these last few months, man, they have been terrible in terms of the content out there. There are a couple of channels that have been uploading good content, the very few content that they upload, like Alex, GBS, Basement Bodybuilding uploaded a couple of good videos that I really liked. Well, NH didn't upload at all, to be honest. But the rest, man, they just suck right now. They just have the same videos over and over and over and over, and it just gets exhausting, man. And it wouldn't be an issue if it was the same topic but with different talking points, like Alex does. But man, it's just the same thing, like the same video, the same talking points, it's just a different thumbnail and different clickbait title. And I really don't see a point outside of like, I want to make a low effort video to get myself out there in the algorithm and just plug in my sponsors so people get give me money, basically. And I have heard some arguments to why you would reuse your old videos. Like, for example, oh, it's for the newcomers, right? For the people that didn't know you before, so they get the information that they need. Well, that's bullshit, because your old videos, unless you're me, don't get deleted, don't get sent to the phantom realm, right? Unless that's the case, that you're going to remake a video with new talking points or with more production value and you're going to delete your old video, right? Or something like that. Unless that's the case, I really don't see a point in making the same video over and over and over. If you're a newcomer, just search the name of the YouTuber, right? Plus the topic at hand, and that video is going to appear and they're going to get the information that they need. And that's it. So it really doesn't make sense to remake a video for a newcomer. On top of that, another argument that I have heard is that we have figured out what works. And it's like, no, we haven't figured out everything. We have figured out an average way to get an average amount of people good results, and that's it. We haven't like figured out everything. There's a lot to learn. For example, how can we make workouts more time efficient? How can we minimize the amount of time we spend in the gym? Because that's a huge issue with hypertrophy training, right? You have to make a lot of time available for the day so you can work out and get your sets, your high effort sets, keep in mind, and a lot of volume for a lot of areas, isolation, compounds. How can we make this more time efficient? There's not a lot of thought put into that. There's not a lot of things to talk about because people haven't been digging into that. So how about we start thinking about that? We haven't figured out that, for example. How about different training modalities? How about using just body weight, for example, like I do? How about using odd lifts like Atlas Power Shrug, sandbags like the Stone Circle, right? We haven't
figured out everything. We just found out a cookie cutter way to get people jacked and that's it. But there are other ways of approaching things, other styles of training with other methodologies that we need to explore, and they might even help the average cookie cutter version as well. So no, we haven't figured out everything and there's a lot to explore. Just recently I made a video about plyometrics, and how many times have we heard about plyometrics for hypertrophy? Very rarely. So yeah, that's not an argument, honestly. The third thing is not an argument in itself, but it is something that I have been told a lot, and that is, maybe you outgrew the content. It's like, what? What do you mean I outgrew the content of a supposed advanced lifter? That doesn't make sense. Like, I'm not advanced. I would say I'm early intermediate at most, honestly. And that really baffles me, because it's like, if you're a supposedly advanced lifter and you are also knowledgeable and also an authority on the matter, right? Why do you only provide basic advice like, oh, apply progressive overload, use double progression, oh, track your rest times, get enough sleep? It's like, well, duh. I mean, I already know that. What you have to say that is more advanced, right? Why are you in a position to call yourself advanced? What do you know? How do you get to your advanced status, right? That's my issue. You don't get that. And I get that most of YouTube fitness are novices. I get that, like, totally. But again, the novices can get entertaining content, because you probably have made videos catering to like novices, like giving advice to novices, and you can just refer them to that video and that's it, and make entertaining content and informative content. And the informative content could be a little bit more advanced, because people that need it will watch it, and then you make entertainment content to get the views and to get yourself into the algorithm. If your priority is to help people, you'll give information to the people that need the information, and then you make a video to get the people that don't need that information to stay entertained. And that's it. That's not that difficult to do, right? So that's another argument that I have heard that I think is total bullshit. So the only reason that I think that you would reuse the same video over and over again is just to do a low effort video, because let's be honest, when you make an informative video, the quality takes a huge drop, because your goal is supposedly to talk about a certain topic and not to make something flashy or something that is going to keep your attention artificially, right? They make a low effort video to just plug in their sponsors, right? Make a 5-minute video with 2 minutes of sponsors and then call it a day. And that's it. And that's what bothers me, because there's nothing wrong, again, with making a living out of fitness. It's fine when the priority is to help people, right? You make a living so you can help more people. That's fine. And also you allow the field of like bodybuilding to expand. But my issue is the current priority is just to make money. That's one thing that I wanted to mention, is the reusing of content. Another thing that I really want to talk about is the absolute milking that the very few concepts that actually emerge, the milking that they received, and they just show the drought that is in the community. For example, a couple of months ago, I made a video about the topic. It was how the Noble Natties were like milking into oblivion the topic of like power building and HIT, and also how many sets a week and stuff like that. Also diet, usually it's diet as well. And we see that, and it's like, we already talked about power building like 60 different times. You aren't adding anything new to the discussion, right? And everyone was making a video about power building, and everyone was making a video about Mike Mentzer. Does HIT work? How many sets a week should we do? And it's like, we already talked about this. We already went through this. We don't need another 68 million thousand bazillion videos about Mike Mentzer. We already know that. We already have seen the videos. Stop with that, right? And back then it was that. Now it's like, first of all, it was the lengthened partial thing, which is the most overrated training concept ever, like Jesus fucking Christ. And it died out pretty fast, thank to God, because it was obnoxious. And it just provided a marginal, like not even significant, I would say, improvements in terms of the results you would get, like very minimal compared to like range of motion, complete range of motion training, or like regular training even. Also, it was the cyborg technique thing for a while. It was the do everything with like perfect tempo. And I'm a huge proponent of slowing down everything and getting more out of less weight. But it got onto a point where it was just a parody of itself and it didn't make any sense at all. Then it moved on to, now it was cyber technique, then lengthened partials. Now we are with stability. Now stability is the meta, right? Now you have to strap onto a bench and magnetize the bench to the floor so you can do a bicep curl. We have people calling push-ups on stable. We got to that point. Like, you show these people like standing and they die because they're like, oh my god, you're working the stabilizers, you're not gonna be able to produce maximal force with the quadriceps, and they fucking internally combust because they can't process the fact that the human body is supposed to move, you know, and is supposed to stabilize itself. And on top of that, they think that full stability is going to provide the maximum amount of like stimulation possible compared to like, for example, stable enough movement, and it's like, no, it's practically the same, and you're actually getting less probably because you're not working the stabilizers, because you're removing all stabilization aspect. For example, comparing lat pull downs to pull ups, pull ups are going to work more muscles than the lat pull downs, and your back's going to look completely different. But in terms of lat hypertrophy, there's not going to be a difference between lat pull downs and pull ups. Like, there's really not going to be that much because pull-ups are stable enough. They are stable enough movements. Same goes with push-ups and bench press. If you're able to equate the loads, right, and you're able to equate the volume and the proximity to failure, you're going to get the same results. You might even get better results with the push-ups in the arms, but in terms of the chest hypertrophy, it's going to be the same. If you compare ring push-ups, for example, with dumbbell pressing, again, the exact same thing. We see it over and over and over. And just need stable enough movements. You don't need a very specific chest press machine to properly stimulate the deltoids. You just have to do an OHP. You have to just have to do a deficit handstand push-up, and that's it. Deficit pike push-up if that's too unstable for you, right? It's the same thing with like biomechanics a while ago with the, oh, we have to follow the fibers of the lats and bullshit like that. And everyone was just like, do pull-ups. Well, it's the exact same thing, only that people are now like not even willing to defend pull-ups for some reason, or other movements in general. I'm not just talking about calisthenics. I'm referring to calisthenics because it's the thing that I do, right? A new concept emerges. We are shown its functionality and how it can be used for hypertrophy, which is valid, but then it gets overblown by the amount of milking it receives, and it get like the message gets lost in translation from one YouTuber to the other, and this one makes a reaction video to the response, and this one makes a tier list to the reaction of the tier list of the response, and we end up with like a mess of things, and the training concepts just becomes parody of itself, and we actually get nothing of value after that. It's really saddening to see how terrible the content has become, and we should really try to improve on what we are doing, and as content creators, we should really think on what we are providing to our audience, because, again, for all of you guys that have like a large audience, think, you're there because of your audience. So, what a way to show respect to just treat them like they're fucking stupid, right? Like they're just consumers and that's it, right? Oh yeah, they don't deserve anything of value. I'm just going to remake the same video again. Oh, this concept is trending. I'm just going to make a quick video of it just so I can profit and that's it. Nah, fuck them. They don't need the adequate information, right? Yeah, I think that's just terrible. And as a content creator, we should look at the audience as what they are. Think about that the next time you want to make a video talking about progressive overload for the 100th time, in which you record yourself using B-roll footage from like 2005 or some shit like that because you're too lazy to record new ones. So I'm going to leave you guys with that. It was really good to get this off my chest. If you want to absolutely destroy me in the comments, feel free to. I really want to hear your perspective because this is something I have been thinking for a while. And if you disagree with me, I'm open to discussion as always. And if you want to prove me wrong, again, I'm not against being proved wrong. It's just my thoughts, my opinions, and what I have been observing. So let me know in the comments below what you think. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.